Hello, friends. Welcome to our read aloud time of The Miraculous Journey of Edward Tulane. So yesterday, Nellie and Lawrence's daughter, Lolly, came. Remember, she was loud, wore bright lipstick, and she basically made fun of Nellie and Lawrence for having their rabbit. And at the end, she had taken him in the trash, and that was the end. We also experienced a new emotion, remember, at the end, Edward said that his heart called out for the first time. So today's chapter, chapter 11, looks like he might be in the trash dump or something. Let's see what happens. Edward ended up at the dump. He lay on top of orange peels, coffee grounds, rancid bacon, and rubber tires. The first night, he was at the top of the garbage heap, and so he was able to look up at the stars and find comfort in their light. In the morning, a short man came climbing through the trash and rubble. He stopped when he was standing on top of the highest pile. He put his hands under his armpits and flapped his elbows. The man crowed loudly. He shouted, "Who am I? I'm Ernest. Ernest, who is king of the world. How can I be king of the world? Because I am king of garbages, and garbages is what the world is made of. Ha, ha, ha. Therefore, I am Ernest, Ernest, who is king of the world." He crowed again. Edward was inclined to agree with Ernest's assessment of the world being made of garbage, especially after his second day at the dump, when a load of trash was deposited directly on top of him. He lay there, buried alive. He could not see the sky. He could not see the stars. He could see nothing. What kept Edward going, what gave him hope, was thinking of how he would find Lolly and exact his revenge. He would pick her up by the ears. He would bury her under a mountain of trash. But after almost 40 days and nights had passed, the weight and the smell of the garbage above and below him clouded Edward's thoughts. And soon he gave up thinking about revenge and gave in to the despair. It was worse, much worse than being buried at sea. It was worse because Edward was a different rabbit now. He couldn't say how he was different. He just knew that he was. He remembered again Pellegrina's story about the princess who had loved nobody. The witch turned her into a warthog because she loved nobody. He understood that now. He heard Pellegrina say, "Disappoint me." "Why?" he asked her. "Why do I disappoint you?" But he knew the answer to that question too now. It was because he had not loved Abilene enough. And now she was gone from him, and he would never be able to make it right. And Nellie and Lawrence were gone too. He missed them terribly. He wanted to be with them. The rabbit wondered if that was love. Day after day passed, and Edward was aware of time passing only because every morning he could hear Ernest performing his dawn ritual, cackling and crowing about being the king of the world. On his 180th day at the dump, salvation arrived for Edward in a most unusual form. The garbage around him shifted, and the rabbit heard the sniffing and panting of a dog. Then came the frenzied sound of digging. The garbage shifted again, and suddenly, miraculously, the beautiful buttery light of late afternoon shone on Edward's face. 180 days at the garbage dump. So we will see what happens with the dog who finds Edward tomorrow. Have a great day. Remember, be kind and smile.